UK, inflation is at 20% and we can't even afford to dine on ashes. In Kenya, the general election has all the finesse of an American insurrection. The Oscars customer service department apologizes to a lady who got booed 50 years ago. And in good old US of A, the president's carer has caught a dose, the ex-president is being pursued through the courts, and Lon Chaney Jr. is out on her ear. This is the Newswire.
The latest action from British railway workers comes days after news that inflation in the UK hit 10% in July for the first time since the 1980s.
Things are so bad, the supermarket Iceland has started offering interest-free microloans to help people afford just the bare essentials.
I do know the figures. About £80 million.
Can't afford that kind of money. Making wild spending commitments. We are saying that we won't allow those price increases to go ahead.
Liz Truss looks set to win the race for number 10 decisively, but most party members still prefer Boris Johnson.
A secure and orderly way.
Six days of tension finally erupts. Streamed live to the nation. Force was met with force.
My name is Sasheen Littlefeather. I'm Apache. I'm representing Marlon Brando this evening. Very regretfully, cannot accept this very generous award.
Former Academy President David Rubin has written to her, calling the abuse she endured, quote, unwarranted and unjustified.
They have had a better life here and their fathers and mothers than they would have had any place else.
First Lady Jill Biden has tested positive for COVID-19.
And will isolate at the vacation home for at least 5 days. The president has tested negative, but will wear a mask indoors for 10 days.
Attorney Harriet Hageman defeating incumbent Liz Cheney in a 30-point landslide.
In a farm in Wyoming, the Cheneys came to accept defeat. Liz Cheney, the latest and most high-profile Republican victim of Donald Trump.
Running for president, if she does, how do you think that's going to go over?
But she won't win a primary, she won't win a state, she won't win a delegate, she won't win anything from this point forward. She's done in politics.
I'm a target of their Atlanta investigation.
Do you believe President Trump is the ultimate target of this investigation?
Testimony is part of a criminal investigation into efforts to overturn the 2020 presidential election.
Late today, Rudy Giuliani under oath before a special grand jury in Atlanta.
Alan Weisselberg, the former Trump Organization chief financial officer, pleaded guilty today to a wide-ranging tax scheme.
And as part of a plea deal, he will need to testify against the Trump Organization this fall.
And if we're wrong, we will be made fools of.
I'm Bobbie Battista. I'll be back next week with my eye on the news.
I know for a lot of Americans, things are still very hard. But if you look at all the facts, you can only come to one conclusion. Things are still very hard.